Michael, state Newton's first law.
An object remains in a state of rest or uniform motion in a straight line unless compelled to change that state by an applied force.
Yes, okay, good. Srihari, what is the another name of the Newton's first law of motion? It's the law of something, we call it. What is that? The name of the first law? Srihari?
I don't know.
No, no. Steffi, what is that? Newton's first law of motion is known as law of?
Inertia.
Law of inertia. Okay. What is inertia, Nandana? What is inertia?
Ability to resist.
Resist what?
Change in the state of motion or rest.
Rest. Okay. Diya, what is the Newton's second law?
Newton's second law of motion states that the rate of change of momentum of an object is directly proportional to the applied and balanced force in the direction of force.
Okay, very good. Nevin, what's the name of Newton's second law? Law of?
Newton's second law.
Newton's second law, we call another name. What is that? Law of? First law, law of inertia. What is second law? Law of?
Momentum.
Momentum. Okay. And now, what do you mean by the word momentum?
It is the product of mass and velocity.
It is the product of mass and velocity. Okay, good. Now, Rin, what is Newton's third law?
For every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction.
Yes. Emmanuel, is this action and reaction force act on same object or different objects? Emmanuel, I think your video has no problem. You can on it. Please. Yeah. Tell me, is this action and reaction force in Newton's third law act on same object or different objects?
Different object, ma'am.
Objects. Okay. So this is about Newton's third law. Now, Evelyn, what is conservation law of momentum? Because we are discussing conservation law of momentum. What is that?
Total momentum before the collision equal to total momentum after the collision.
Total momentum before collision is equal to total momentum after collision. So collision, it is not always not a collision, but we are just giving that name of collision. This is same in the case of a gun is firing. Okay. The bullet moving. When the gun fires, bullet moves. So before firing, momentum before firing also equal to momentum after firing. So it's not only collision, any instances like that. Okay. Similarly, we can archers, when archers are making an arrow to move, that is the time before that and after that. Before that and after that, both are conservation of momentum is conserved. But what is the main condition is that there should not be any other unbalanced force. If there is any other unbalanced force, this conservation law of momentum will never satisfy. And do you remember conservation of energy? You are learned in 9th standard, I think. What do you mean by conservation of energy, Atul? Conservation law of energy.
Energy can neither be created nor be destroyed.
It only
can be changed from different forms.
So this is the same thing. So this conservation of momentum, the basic is mainly based on this conservation law of energy. That is the reason. Okay. There are some changes in energy, but the total sum, that is kinetic energy plus potential energy, is equal to zero. That is what we have learned in 9th standard. Okay. That means loss in kinetic energy equal to gain in potential energy. So this all things are come in this. Okay. That's why. So let us now continue with that derivation. So I think everyone has copied that. One second, I tell you the situation. There are two balls, blue ball and pink ball. blue ball and pink ball is in the same direction, the initial velocity of the blue ball is greater than final greater than the initial velocity of the pink ball. So the blue ball collide the pink ball. When blue ball collide with the pink ball, blue ball exert a force, that is action force. So who is going and colliding? Blue ball. And in turn, the pink ball exert a reaction force. So both the forces are equal and opposite in magnitude. Okay. And after colliding with them, both of them are moving independently. So in that, we are going to prove the conservation law of momentum. So already told, initial momentum of the ball 1, m1, u1. If you wanted to identify in your textbook, it is not given this derivation. Okay. So in the textbook, it is only just given PA. So if you want in bracket, if you go through the book, you will not see, because some of the things in the NCERT book is not given. So we have to refer other books. So that's what I'm telling you. So those who want, you can write it down. M1 U1 is equal to PA. So by A is the momentum of the initial momentum of the first ball. So you can connect it. Otherwise, if you look into the textbook, ma'am, where is this derivation? It's not given. They are just mentioned PA and P dash A. So I am just giving you derivation. And final momentum of the ball, you can, in your textbook, it is given P dash A. So we are going to get this derivation in terms of it. So we have to study that P dash A. Now, change in momentum. Change in momentum, final momentum minus initial momentum. So there you can, those who have written, you can just sideways, you can write in bracket P dash A minus PA. This is for not to make confusion with the textbook and this. Okay. Then rate of change in momentum of the ball, that is M1 V1 minus M1 U1, and M1 take it out. Then finally you are getting. So rate of change in momentum is directly proportional to the force. That is what we have studied in Newton's second law. So that is what I have written here, F12. Okay. So mass acted on ball 2 by first ball. So I think this is clear to you. Now let us go to the next one. Similarly, same thing in the case of a second ball. This is in the case of the second ball. Okay. So you can write it down in the similarly. I am not writing the steps here because similarly we have written. So you don't go for entire like initial momentum of the second ball, initial final momentum of the second ball. You don't have to write again. So you can just write it here. Similarly, rate of change in momentum of ball 2, F21, because there also force is directly proportional. M2 into V2 minus U2 by T. You can write it there. P dash B. So in this case, in your textbook, it is used the letter. Why it is? Same color. Okay. There you can write P1 B minus PB. PB divided by T. Okay. Instead of in bracket, you can write F21 M2 into V2 minus U2 P1 B minus PB by T. In CRT, it is given final momentum of the second ball P1 B and this one. Okay. Now we are going to apply the third law of motion here. By third law of motion, what is that? Action force and reaction force both are equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. So you can write F12 is equal to minus F21. Then substitute the values of F12 and minus F21. So M1 into V1 minus U1 divided by T, which is equal to minus of this. So don't forget minus of this quantity. So minus of M2 into V2 minus U2 by T. Now T, both the time is equal, so we can get cancel. Our equation is going to be M1 into V1 minus U1 is equal to minus M2 into v2 minus u2. Now we are going to expanding it. I'll give you time. You first just look and understand. I'll give you time to write. So next, m1 into v1 minus u1 is equal to minus of m2 into v2 minus u2. Expand it. When you expand, m1 v1 minus m1 u1, which is equal to minus m2 v2, minus and minus of u2. So plus m2 u2. So we just expanded both. Now what we have done, we just rearrange all the u terms put together in one side, all v terms put together another side. So when you put together, actually you are getting like this, m1 v1 plus m2 v2 is equal to m1 u1 plus m2 u2. So if you follow this order, you are getting like this. But instead of that, I am just made initial momentum, all initial momentum of the both balls in one side, and final momentum of the both balls are other side. Okay, because that is our equation. So by rearranging, we got it, all the initial momentum of the first ball plus initial momentum of the second ball equal to final momentum of the first ball plus final momentum of the second ball. Thus, we can write it. After that, we can write it, total momentum of the system before collision is equal to total momentum of the system after collision. So below that, you can just write this NCRT, what is given. That is PA plus PB is equal to P dash A plus P dash B. So after writing the statement, thus PA plus PB is equal to P dash A plus P dash B. That's enough. Okay, so that you get the connection between your NCRT textbook and the derivation. So this is the derivation, carry 5 marks. Okay, to prove conservation law of momentum for the two balls in collision. Okay, so first you state. I say it. Yes, Achyut.
This is there in the printed note also.
Printed note I will give. I have not typed, but I will give. Okay, you want it? Then I'll give. Okay. Then one more thing, children. See that, write and study. This is 5 mark question. Okay. So the question is like that: state conservation law of momentum and prove this theory in the basis of collision of two balls. Okay, so that is how we have to draw that picture of the balls u1 v1 v2, and then come to this. Okay, yeah, so we have completed conservation law of momentum, and we have learned third law of motion, also known as law of impulse. So just know, just write, what do you mean by impulse recently? So I hope everyone understood. Anyone have a doubt regarding this derivation? I think it is also explained in your 9th standard book. That time you may not have studied. Okay, same thing. Yeah. So now we are moving on to the impulse. What do you mean by the word impulse? Already I told, the third law is known as law of impulse. So in 9th standard, we are not mentioning about the impulse. So in the plus one, we are going to impulse. So what is impulse? Impulse is the force which is acting in very short time. The force which is acting in very short time. Impulse force which is acting in very short time. And we can represent impulse I is equal to F into T. So total force, how much force is acting, multiplied with the time. So that is not as impulse. So nowadays IPL is going on. You can see your players, your favorite players are hitting the six. That is an application of impulse. Okay, so just imagine, sometimes some of the players, when they hit, it goes to 130 meter, maybe beyond pavilion. And there was an occasion there, since it is in Abu Dhabi, Gulf countries, now IPL is taking place. I don't know, you must have noticed one funny thing. Someone has hit the six and went to the road. road of the golf and someone is running and picking up the ball and going away. Have you seen that? A funny video was there. Recent IPL, I don't know how many are watching it. So when my husband was watching that time, I just see that funny thing. That means that much impact. Someone, I don't know who hit to the six. It gone beyond the pavilion and it fell down on the road. So nowadays Corona, only the franchises relatives are there in the pavilion. Others all are no people inside. But outside there are people is listening what is happening in Gulf. Okay. So someone is on the road who was standing. It was very funny. Someone's ball went on the road and he ran and picked and he ran away. He did not give. So that is what I'm talking about. That funny thing is here. It is the application of impulse. Impulse means it's the impact of the force is very much large. Impact of the force is very much large. So it is the force which is active very short time, and it is not a simple force. It is a very large force. This is the same reason someone falls from the 5-floor building or someone falls from 2-floor building. Naturally, what happened to their body? What happened to them? You know, some people get committing suicide. Some are falling from the construction site. The people will turn up with the fractured bone. Sometime you will die because of this impact, impulse. Okay, now on the basis of Newton's second law. So by Newton's second law, we can get one more equation for this. By Newton's second law, force is directly proportional, correct? Force is directly proportional to change in momentum. That is M into V minus U. Thus, impulse also can write in terms of F, you can also write it is the change in momentum into time. We can also write it is change in momentum in time. So this is for your exam. I mean, it's problems. Sometimes problems, momentum is given, no force is given. So you have to find out the impulse. So in that, we can use this equation also. Change in momentum into time.
Ma'am.
Yes.
F directly proportional to M into V minus U by T, right?
Yes. F is directly proportional to M into V minus U by T. Okay. Then, what is, if you remove that, what we are going to get equation M into V minus U by T. So, yeah, F T is equal to M into V minus U. So here it is right. It's correct. Ft is equal to M into V minus U. You have to write that way. Impulse is Ft. Ft is equal to M into V minus U. Correct. Thank you, Punya. Ft is equal to M into V minus U. Yes.
So no correction in F proportional to M into V minus U.
There is connection is there. Once you have to find a change in momentum, only we can find a rate of change in momentum. Correct. Okay. So if Ft is equal to M into V minus U, then what is F? From the same equation, you will get the same equation, no? Correct? Yes. And also we can find out the time from this equation. Short time. Time is equal to M into V minus U by F. So that way also we can write. So just say Ft is equal to M into V minus U. Okay. So now we are moving on to next one, concurrent forces. Concurrent forces and common forces which is used in mechanics. Okay. So next heading, we will understand concurrent forces. First, understand what do you mean by equilibrium of a particle. So write the heading, equilibrium of a particle, then only we can understand the concurrent forces. Equilibrium of a particle. See, children, equilibrium of particle is more or less just like balanced force. What is a balanced force? I explained to you, no? Balanced force. Meenakshi, what happened to your video? Meenakshi? Gayatri, can you tell me what do you mean by the term balanced force? Balanced force, unbalanced force.
The force acting on an object is same.
Yeah, will be the same.
And it cancels each other.
Yeah, balanced force. So balanced force means total forces acting on an object cancel each other and it become a zero. It's a zero balance condition. So equilibrium of a particle attains at this balanced force condition. Equilibrium means stability. Stability of an object in the universe. Just like we each of us. We each of us can do whatever we want. It is our under control on the surface of the earth. We already know that earth is pulling us towards the center of the earth. But at the same time, we also can remain, or you can have our own existence in the universe, because there are so many forces which is acting on us simultaneously to cancel the gravitational force. That is what I told you about upthrust. That is what I told about upthrust. So in this case, instead of upthrust, we are going to learn one more type. Another name is normal reaction force. So more than upthrust, we call it in this, according to this situation, we call it upthrust. Instead of upthrust, we call it normal reaction force. So normal reaction force only on the surface of the earth. But when you go to the liquid or when you go to the sea, it is upthrust again. Okay, not normal reaction force, it is upthrust again. So since we are in the state above the surface of the earth, the force which is acting against the gravitational force, we call it as normal reaction force. So normal reaction force and gravitational force, they both are equal in opposite. Okay, similarly, there is a frictional force by the air. So there is a frictional force by the air, but you overcome that frictional force by applying more force. So all these things, when all these forces are acting on us simultaneously and it cancel each other, we can say that a particle and object attain equilibrium. Okay, so that is equilibrium. So what is equilibrium? Equilibrium of a particle in mechanics refers to a state when the net external force on the particle is zero, whether the particle is either at rest or in uniform motion, either the particle is moving or not moving. Now all of you not moving, you are sitting in front of the laptop, so at this time you are attaining equilibrium. Okay, suppose you are driving the car. The car is moving with a constant velocity without accelerating. Then you are attained. That car attained an equilibrium condition. So that we can understand. Okay, so equilibrium of a particle in mechanics refers to a state when the net external force on the particle is zero, whether the particle is either at a state of rest or in uniform motion. Either at rest or in uniform motion. For example, suppose two forces acting near you, F1 and F2, then equilibrium will be F1 is equal to minus F2, or F1 plus F2 is equal to zero. F1 plus F2 is equal to zero. Suppose there are three forces, then F1 plus F2 plus F3 will be zero. So that is equilibrium condition. If there are n number of forces are acting, suppose n number of forces are acting, then you can write F1 plus F2 plus F3 plus etc. plus Fn is equal to 0. And these forces which is acting at this equilibrium, we call it as concurrent forces. So this is known as concurrent forces. The forces which is equal in magnitude but opposite in direction, we attain equilibrium condition, and these forces are known as concurrent forces. So if you look at the picture, first one we are asking for F1 and F2. There are only two concurrent forces, F1 and F2. But in the case of second picture, we have three forces, F1, M2, F3. They are acting in x-axis, y-axis, z-axis, but still they are concurrent, they are equal, so it gets cancelled. So when you apply triangle law, if you apply triangle law vector addition, then any one of the force, suppose F1 and F2 are moving, F2 are two forces, and third forces will be act like a completing the triangle. That's it. Suppose three forces. Okay. So in the case of three forces, triangle of vector addition, if there are two forces, forces indicating side of the triangle, the third force will be the resultant of that force. So it can complete the triangle. So that is one feature of a concurrent forces, but this is in the case of three forces. I hope so.
Ma'am.
Yes.
I didn't complete, ma'am, last page.
Okay. I will show you. I'm just checking because last day I three videos I did not record. So I'm just checking in between. Okay. The reason is between, if the shawl or something touches the record or something is going on, I don't know. So that's why.
Ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, can you define concurrent force again?
Yes, I'll define. Okay. We are coming to that next slide. Did you complete this?
Yes.
No, ma'am.
Okay, Achyut, we wait. Okay.
Ma'am, So can we say equilibrium exists because of concurrent forces?
Yes. So a particle attain stability or equilibrium because of the presence of concurrent forces. Okay. So concurrent forces are those forces whose lines of action meet at a point. So this is little more scientific way. Because whichever all the forces are acting, it should produce, it should start from a common point. So that is what we can say. Concurrent forces are the forces whose line of action meets at a point. And the representation of concurrent forces in terms of a diagram, we call it as free body diagram. So we are going to little more scientific way of defining it. Simple way you can understand which are the forces acting on an object to attain equilibrium is known as concurrent forces. Little more, if you have more specific and more scientific way, this is the actual definition. Concurrent forces are forces.